We are now joined in the studio by the Minister of Health and Social Services, Dr. Kalumbi Shangula, to answer some of the questions being raised following the COVID-19 positive cases announcement. Good evening, Dr. Shangula.
And good evening.
Now, what does this say of our testing equipment and detection ability at airports? The couple who were tested positive for COVID-19 by a private doctor on Friday and had just earlier on the same day also been tested, and upon arrival at Jose Cotaco International Airport, no symptoms were detected. How effective is our testing equipment in that scenario?
Thank you very much for that question. Let me just explain what we are doing at the airport. At the airport, we have thermal scanners, which are equipment which are used in most of all the airports, including South Africa, United States of America, etc., etc. Now, these scanners, they pick up the temperature, high temperature. If a person has got high fever, then this equipment will be able to pick that up, and then further measures will be taken in relation to that particular individual. Now, what happened in this case, the couple, they were screened at the airport. We do screening, not testing. We do screening. And then when they went to the practitioner, medical doctor, the doctor, having seen the signs and symptoms, suspected that the case correspond to case definition of coronavirus. And what the doctor did, he did not do the test, he simply collect the specimen. The specimen were then sent to the private laboratory, and then that private laboratory sent the specimen to South Africa for testing. And the result came out last night. So what happened at the airport and what happened at the practice, they are two different procedures altogether. Now, one of the first symptoms of coronavirus is high fever, and that is what the thermal scanner are doing, are picking up. It's possible that either the couple, they were in incubation period, which lasts between 2 and 14 days, with a mean period of about five days. Or the person might have taken something which lower the temperature, so that when it comes through the screening, the temperature was not detected as abnormal.
You have announced, Minister Shangula, that all the people who were in contact with the affected couple would be traced and tests conducted on them. Now, would this include all who shared a flight with them as well, those that were on the plane, of course, employees at the accommodation facility where they were booked in, and whoever came into contact with these employees?
Yes. When the passenger complete, there is a mandatory form which they have to complete. They give the information as to the name of the person, the details of the person, and then also the seat number. So then it will be possible to trace that who were in the immediate vicinity of that number of seat. Now, those are the target for tracing, especially as long as everybody who has been in contact with a person, either at the establishment or en route to the establishment from the airport. So the contact tracing have started already last night and is still continuing. All those whom we think that they might have been in close contact, they will be traced, and then appropriate measure will be taken.
Naturally, Dr. Shangula, there is a sense of panic amongst the public. Now, can you tell us with certainty that the virus has not reached the residential areas of Kadutura suburb, where some of the workers from the establishment in question actually live?
Well, let me maybe explain that. for a person to contract the virus, there are certain conditions. It means that that person must have been in close contact. So, in close contact, so to say, a distance of less than a meter. Now, if
like the way we are sitting at the moment,
exactly.
Okay.
If maybe in the establishment, the person who take care of the floor technician, is maybe 2 meters or 3 meters. He's never been in close contact. The possibility of contracting the virus is less, unless there was a very, very close contact, or there has been body contact, like shaking hands or whatever, or having touch on a surface where the virus might have been deposited. So in any case, we do not take any chance. Anybody whom we feel that has been in close contact with the individuals will be traced, monitored, and if necessary, further steps can be taken.
How successful do you think do you believe the ministry's tracing will be? I mean, given the fact that at the airport screening took place but no symptoms were detected, how effective can this be, surely?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I believe that the contacts may not be such a wide net. This is a couple which is visiting Namibia. It means that it's not somebody who lives in Namibia with many acquaintances who might have gone to visit, I mean, to receive at the airport and coming, traveling in a big group, etc., or getting into the house where there are so many people. Simply coming from the airport and booked in into the guest house. The likelihood that he was not feeling also well, that he could have gone through town and visit places, is remote.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Talking about the guest house now, let's talk about the school Vintage Gymnasium, which is now under lockdown for 2 weeks. Can you share more details around the reasons for that? And could the accommodation facility where the Spanish couple were residing or were booked in similarly be brought under lockdown as well?
Immediately when the results were received and the location of the couple was identified, the whole establishment was already under lockdown, and police were dispatched to the place to secure the place so that nobody goes in and nobody goes out. Now, with regard to the school, it was established that one of the people being at that establishment is actually a teacher at the school, and that is the reason why that particular school was put under lockdown, because there must have been contact when the teacher was at the establishment and goes to school. So there is a high possibility. That is the reason.
In your statement earlier, Dr. Shangula, you mentioned that travelers are expected to complete a health declaration. What actually is that upon the arrival in the country, of course, but what exactly is that, and what is the purpose? What purpose does it serve in the first place?
Yes, that is what I alluded to earlier, that the person give all the details on that form. There is a space for the name, then your travel history, where have you been, what is your seat number. And that help to say where did this person go, and where are the likelihood that this person might have picked up the virus. If one is coming from a highly affected country or transit through a highly affected country, so the likelihood is that the person might have picked up. But it helped us, apart with the training, I mean with the tracing, it also helped us to know the history of the person and who else we need to contact.
You mentioned about the screening earlier on. Now, talking about the frontline staff at the Jose Akutako International Airport, are they wearing protective gear? Are they protected? What's your stance on that?
Before the passenger goes to the staff where their passport are stamped to immigration, they first go through the screening. If there is a suspicion that they might have been, this person might have been affected, will not be allowed to proceed, will be taken somewhere else. Now, those who have been cleared, it's assumed that they are healthy, and therefore they can proceed to the immigration. And of course, in that instances, they would not pose any danger to the immigration officials.
Is there need for Namibians to actually be fearful about this? Is there need for panic?
There is no need for panic.
Why do you say so?
Now, for the reason that this is not a local transmission. This is an imported case. In other words, there was nothing in Namibia up to the time they arrived. And maybe there, I also need to correct the information which was received earlier to say these are Spanish citizens. It emerged from the Spanish embassy that they are actually Romanians who passed through Spain, then Doha, and then Namibia. So they are not Spanish citizens. Yeah.
And your final word to Namibians in terms of reassurance?
I will just want to inform the Namibia that we have measures in place to detect early and to contain the virus. But what we need the cooperation from the public. Mm-hmm. The public must understand that they must maintain personal hygiene at all time. And then also to not to be as close as possible to people who are sick and who might have the virus. There is no need to panic, because in the state of panic, you are likely to do wrong things. Just know how the disease is contracted from one individual to another individual. If you know the pathway, then you will know where to break the pathway. That is very important. And again, I also want to caution the public. There are so many news information, wrong information, disinformation going around in the social media. And please, if you receive something like that, do not propagate it. Phone us. We have now a toll-free number to ask for the correct information before you pass it over, because it only creates panic and confusion among the public. So let us all be responsible people.
Minister Shangula, let's talk a little bit about the other schools, the private and the government schools as well. What is the ministry's stance on that?
You have heard what His Excellency the President has said.
That's right.
In his statement, that all mass gathering they will be suspended. Mass gathering, it means a place where there are many people coming together, be it a school, being it at a soccer match, being it a church, being it anywhere, as long as being at funerals, it means those places where many people can come together and where the risk of exposure is increased.
So other schools could possibly also be on lockdown. Is that what you're saying?
What I'm saying is that currently now there is a national team, technical team, which are looking at the implementation of the decision which were announced by His Excellency the President. And very soon there will be an announcement what is going to happen in this case, whether it's school, whether it's soccer match, it whatever. So those one, the modalities will be worked out by the technical team.
Minister, thank you so much for that comment, and we also hope and appreciate the fact that we can at least overcome this as we go along. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
And that was Health Minister Dr. Kalumbi Shangula briefing us on COVID-19, the two new cases that were confirmed in Namibia, and that there's no reason for Namibians to be alarmed or concerned about it, as everything is under control.